Hi everybody, welcome to my channel. I'm just going to do a quick video today. You know how I am, I always say quick and then it's, you know, 40 minutes later and I'm still recording. But we're going to try to make this one quick today. I got some new Soak Off Fiber Glass Base. And I have used this several times and I love it. And I did a couple of clients. And one of them I did a French manicure on. I am anti-French manicure generally. I'm a little bit better about them now. When I started doing nails like in the 90s, that's how old I am. All anyone wanted was French manicures. That's all I did for months. And anyway, I did a French manicure. I thought it looked really cute and I was gonna show you how I did that. I haven't top coated these yet, so I thought I'd just show you right off the bat. I am going to swatch these for you, but I'm using the Madame Glam palette and the Soak Off Fiber Glass Base. There is a clear, a pink, and a beige. This is kind of peachy, but beige. So I started with the pink base. It's a base coat. You don't have to put anything else underneath it. Here are the ingredients. It is Madame Glam, so of course it's always vegan, cruelty-free, 21-free, HEMA-free, and palm oil-free. I am not allergic to this. Thank goodness, because I was scared. But it is beautiful. I just have the pink base on this hand. I haven't done the... I haven't put the pigment on the tips for the French yet. There is also a clear, and I don't know, when I paint it on, you can see kind of a little bit of fibers. I do have some other fiber gel that I actually ended up throwing in the trash because as soon as I used this one time, it's like, okay, I don't need that stuff anymore. And I only use that to repair nails. You can use it for repairs or anything like that. I do have a discount code with Madame Glam. Of course, it's Skyline30 because it's 30% off. You can use that on anything across the board at Madame Glam. I don't make a commission from that. Just helps you out. And if you follow my link, I appreciate it. That way, they at least know that you watched my video and heard about it from me. So let's get started with the beige. Oh wow, my air conditioner kicked off. It's really quiet for once in here. All right, so you can see on the tip, when I pull that off, you can see sometimes there's little sticky eppies. There's one on the brush, if you can see that. So it does have a little bit of texture, but it evens out and it smooths out. In true Madame Glam fashion, they just level right out. Now, I noticed when I applied it on clients, I did have a couple times that I had to, after I got done, hit the tip with a file just to kind of even that out. And I do have one right here, if you can see that, that I'll have to hit with a file after I top coat. I'm not worried about it right now. But I'm going to cure that. Oh, I cured them for 60 seconds. But it's a base. Yeah, 1 minute. Still 1 minute. So you can build with these. You can build an apex. You can build them out and make a little length. You can fix, repair a nail. I am loving this. I'm hoping that I haven't heard back from either one of the clients yet. When they come back in a couple weeks, we'll see how it did. My nails, I have not wiped off or top coated, so those are sticky. I'm trying to keep from getting anything on them. This was just one coat. I did apply it kind of more like you would a builder. I did apply it kind of thick. So I think I'll just show you how I do that. You are going to just first just do a pretty thin coat, like a slip layer. You're not going to cure that. It's just to have a base to move it on. And then apply it as thick as you want. I mean, I don't think you really have to do it very thick, just because, I mean, it's already got those fibers in it. So it's already stronger than a regular base. I mean, I would say it's even stronger than a builder base, but what do I know, right? There's the pink, and I'm going to flip that over and let it level out a little bit. And that's good to cure. And the clear. Now the clear, I think, I'll get my flashlight out here because I think you can see the fiber in the clear. Maybe if I just put something black behind it. I don't know, can you, I can see them, but I don't know if you can. They're just barely, you can see, they look like little scratches. Now the fear with fiber before is when you file it. Oh, that made this really nice. When you file it, you kind of have to be careful because that's flying around in the air. So you might want to wear a mask when you file that. But I don't know. I don't feel like this will be as bad as the regular fiber stuff. You know, I have a desk collector, so I'm not really worried about filing this. So I have this brush. I am not sure where I got that because it's not on there anywhere. I think I got it from a PPU or maybe from Lantern and Wren. I'm not sure. But it's just kind of a flat stippling brush to apply pigments with or to burnish in powders. So I really kind of want to use this pearl on this hand. I just don't want a harsh line. I just want it kind of blended down. Ooh, I like that pearl. But I'll show you how to fix that line. Sorry, I'm hitting my camera. I'll show you how to fix that line. Because I'm just using the sticky that is already on there from that base. You could also start with this pink and do your base if you don't think that's opaque enough or you've got a little damage. I have some damage here, and you know, make your base more opaque. I'm tempted to use like the gold or something, but we'll just go ahead and use the white. Ooh, that's pretty. You could absolutely just use polish. I like using pigment because then you don't have a ridge from that polish. And I know you can smooth it out with top coat, but it still is kind of always there. Ooh, I like that. Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and use that powder, that pink, kind of to blend out. All right, here they are. There's pink and the beige and the clear. And I'm just going to use my Madame Glam No Wipe Top Coat. And then if you have any, you know, sticky outies, you can just hit it with a file after. All right, I'm going to have to send a picture of these to Carlene because I always give her such a hard time when she asks for a friendship manicure. And then I do it on myself. So you absolutely could just do these on your nails and top coat them and be done. Just to strengthen your nails. All right, you guys. That's all I have for you today. Thank you so much for joining me. What do you think? Do you want to try these fiberglass base gels? I'm loving them, but I do wish they white. We need a white one. Thanks, Madame Glam. Thank you, guys. Bye. The links will be down below. Stay tuned for a little fun video here at the end. Bye. Oh, you want to play with the big dog? But you're afraid of the big dog. He's got another rat terrier that lives next door that loves Penny and comes and kisses her and just can't wait to play with her. And this little guy, look at him. He's like, I'm gonna get you. But as soon as Penny goes toward him. Hello, baby. Oh. I think he wants you to chase him, Penny. Are you having fun playing with that puppy? He's playing hide and seek with you. Catch me if you can, is what he's playing. Well, come here. Well, come here. Well, come here. Baby. Hello, baby. It's okay. She just wants to play with you. You're a good girl. Yeah. You going to play? You going to play? Get your ball. Oh, yeah, go see if he'll play ball with you. Tim, come play ball with me.